Hello friends, I am DK and I welcome you all to your own channel. And I further welcome you to our tutorial series Zero to Hero in episode number 45. Today we are covering very important indicator known as ADX or Average Directional Index, which is quite popular as well. So we will learn today what is ADX as an indicator, how we can use the indicator to make an interpretation of the market, especially with regard to the prevailing trend, and then how we can combine with other studies to understand as to how this indicator can be useful tool to enhance our accuracy in the market when we analyze or technically perform the analysis on the price chart. So friend, if you are watching this video, have not yet subscribed the channel, do subscribe, enable the notification bell so that you remain notified all the time for upcoming uploads. And friends, if you are interested in the membership of this channel, you can click on the link provided in the description box of this video below to know various types of benefits and perks that are being offered under each membership program. So friends, let's move ahead to start learning all about ADX as an indicator. So friends, what is Average Directional Index, which is in short form is known as ADX? Friends, it is an indicator which does not tell you about the prevailing trend. It only tells you about the strength behind that prevailing trend. So let us be very clear about it. It only measures the strength of the prevailing trend. It doesn't tell you about whether it's a bull market or a bear market. So if market is trending up, it will tell you the strength of that uptrend market. And if the market is trending down, it will let you know as to how strong is the downtrend market. So it is an oscillator which oscillates between the values 0 to 100, and its value is significant to understand as to what is the strength of prevailing trend. So unlike RSI, ADX does not determine whether the trend is bullish or bearish. It only measures the strength of the prevailing trend. Now let us understand very quickly the history behind this particular indicator. This indicator was primarily developed for commodity traders. It was developed by J.W. Wilder way back in 1978, which is now, even now it is very, very popular indicator to measure the strength. So later on, across the market, wherever the trading is done, this has been adopted by the technical analyst. So it is being used by the commodity market, analyst of the commodity market, or stock market, or currency pairs, doesn't matter, because this particular index is only used to find out the strength of the prevailing trend, whether it is an uptrend or a downtrend. So what are the elements of ADX as an indicator? So friends, there are three broader elements of this indicator, and those are guided by the price movement. So price is the basic input parameter which is used to arrive at the values of ADX. But in order to arrive the value of ADX, first we have to arrive the directional movement of the price. So it has element number one, which is called plus directional movement index. In short form, it is known as DI plus. What does it mean? When the market makes higher highs, which means the market is moving up, so this movement of higher high is compared with the low of the market. This is how the value of DI on plus side is arrived. Similarly, when the market makes lower low, means consecutive low, so it compares as to how the market is making lower low. So makes a comparison with the current high. This is how minus DI value is arrived at. And over the period, various values of DI plus and DI minus are smoothened to understand. And then after smoothening, it is plotted. So that it tells you even the direction of the trend. If you refer to the DI alone, then it will tell you whether the bulls are dominating the market or the bears are dominating the market. But here, the sole purpose of ADS as an indicator, which is the third element, is ADX line. The value of ADX line tells us the strength of the prevailing trend. However, the DI plus and DI minus line, which are plotted on the price chart or the separate window of ADX, can tell us as to when the trend is changing. But DI values doesn't indicate the strength part of it. It is the ADX line which is derived with the values of DI plus and DI minus over the period gives us that information about the strength part of the prevailing trend. So friends, broader there are three elements of ADX as an indicator. So let us first understand DI, plus DI and minus DI as to how these are used to make an interpretation out of their movement or their lines on the price chart. Now friends, after having understood the interpretation aspect of DI, we will look into the ADX line as to how that is used to make an interpretation for strength of the prevailing trend. And then we will go to the price chart so that I can explain you over the price chart as to how these movements take place and can help us to make an interpretation in the market for the prevailing trend and its strength. So friend, interpretation of DI can be made in such a fashion. When plus DI line is above minus DI line, it is considered the trend is bullish. And when minus DI line is above plus DI line, then it is considered bearish. Very simple. Opposite to each other. Now plus DI, whenever it crosses above minus DI line, it indicates possible reversal in the trend. And if minus DI is crossing over plus DI, it indicates the trend reversal to bearish trend. Now the question here is, it is just an indicator and all those indicators are derived from either price or volume or in combination of those. So this is an indicator which is deriving its value from price. And hence, it is a supporting tool. It cannot be used as a standalone indicator to make final assessment and formulate the trading strategy. We have to study along with the price and volume and combine other technical studies. So this can assist us to find out the overall market situation with respect to the strength of the prevailing trend. Because as a trader, what we are interested in, the most popular method in the market is to follow the trend, to chase the trend, and maximum money is made when we follow the trend. Trend is our friend. And if we know what is the strength of our friend, the possibility of making money becomes higher if you are a trend following trader. So ADX is primarily used to ascertain the strength of my friend, your friend, as a trader. So let us now go ahead to understand interpretation of ADX line with respect to its value and how it can be interpreted in a very simple fashion. So friends, now let us understand the scale of strength in ADX indicator. But before that, I would like to tell you that majority of the technical analysts, what they do, they only use the ADX line. They just simply don't use the DI plus and DI minus, because in order to make an assessment of the market, whether it is trending up or trending down, the best way it is to understand the market structure. If market is making higher highs and higher lows, it is an uptrending market, market is in a markup phase. And if the market is making lower highs and lower lows kind of structure, it is a downtrending market in a markdown phase. And we can take help of various moving averages that you might have seen on this channel. We do the technical analysis using EMA 21, EMA 55 for short term, and SMA 89, SMA 144, SMA 233 for intermediate and long term trend analysis. So we should not be I can only share with you, I don't use DI plus and DI minus to ascertain which kind of trend is prevailing. However, ADX line can be useful to ascertain the strength of the prevailing trend. The moment market structure has indicated us that the trend is up, then we want to know the strength of the trend. Or the trend is down and you want to initiate the short selling position. So you want to know the strength of my friend, that is a downtrending market. So what is the strength of that downtrending market? So many a times the technical analysts use only single line of this indicator, which is an ADX line. So now let us understand the scale of strength in ADX indicator to make an interpretation. So friends, this is the chart, which is a, you can say, the ready reckoner kind of thing, where if the value of ADX is in between 0 to 20, the market is considered to be range bound, sideways market. The market is either consolidating, but it is not in the trading range. So here the market is in sideways, and it is always said in the sideways market, one should not try to trade. If you are a very experienced trader and the range is enough and you can gauge the market psychology, you can indulge into range trading method if risk reward ratio is favorable. However, when the value of ADX is in between 0 to 20, it is considered a sideways market or a range bound market. When the value of indicator is in between 20 to 45, if it is 20 plus and in between 45, it is considered the trend is strong. That strong trend could be uptrend or could be downtrend. The value doesn't indicate the nature of the market. It only indicates the strength of the prevailing trend. So market structure will tell you whether the trend is up or the trend is down. Once you know the trend is up, you can use the value of ADX to conclude whether the trend is strong enough or not. So 20 plus to 45 strong trend, or it may indicate the moment the value has crossed above 20, you can say the trend is building up, and up to 45 the trend will remain strong. If the values goes past 45 and up to 60, it is considered very, very strong trend. However, this is a very rare occasion. The moment price is you can even feel it, that the price is moving and it's quite far extended and overextended price situation with respect to the moving average 21 and 55 may warrant some kind of exhaustion coming forth and market may correct. And when the value is 60 plus to 100, which is extremely strong trend, however, such occasion is extremely rare. And even if that happens once in a while, such trend is not sustainable. The market will see a very huge parabolic move on upside or a downside, and then this is not sustainable. So, the moment ADX value crosses 20 plus, it gives that the trend is gaining strength. It is at that simple. Some of the traders consider 25 plus and 25 below. If it goes 25 plus, the strength of the trend is very good. And if it is below 25, so it's all about your own experience when you combine with other studies in the market. So friend, now let's move to the price chart to have a look to how this indicator looks and how we can use it. So friends, this is the price chart of Divi's Laboratory in daily time frame. I have selected this chart to explain you because this is the chart which is a typically trend is up. It is making higher highs and higher lows, and in between there has been several correction or short term downtrend which was observed on this particular chart. So I will first let you know as to how this indicator is selected and placed on your chart. So this is the indicator. I am going to select this as first. I will select ADX. So I'll type average directional index. Now you can see average directional index has come over here. So I am putting it, I am selecting it. Now it has come on the chart here. Now this particular indicator is indicating only single line. So this is the ADX line, which is a single line, which will indicate, which will help us to know the strength of prevailing trend. And you can see the scale 20, 40, 60. So we have to simply understand, if it is above 20, the trend is strong. If it is below 20, it's a sideways movement. Now another thing, if you want to have a combination of directional movement index, that is plus DI, minus DI and ADX in one window, that is also possible. So I am here selecting directional. You can see directional movement index. So I am selecting this. Now it contains three lines. Now I'll adjust this line, customize it so that you understand better. Now I am selecting ADX is indicated by red line and DI is indicated by blue line and minus DI this. So for the purpose of easy understanding, I am changing plus DI to green color. I am making little thicker. So this is plus DI. Minus DI, I'll select it to red color because it is minus. So I am selecting a red color. And now what I do, ADX line on the same chart, so that we are not confused, I am selecting a dark color, say maybe black color. So this is done. Now we can see very clearly the three distinct lines. The green color is indicating plus DI, the red color is indicating minus DI, and this black color line is indicating the value of ADX. Now in order to customize the single line, I change it to the black color, this one as well. so that to have the similarity. Now the question here is, some of the people use in this format where it has the value of di plus, di minus and adx line. And some people, they use this indicator only to find out the strength of prevalent end. So they use only this particular window which shows adx line only. So there is no trace of confusion. Now let me explain you. The trend is up and here it is correcting. Whenever there is an uptrend market and correction takes place, a pullback takes place, there is an upcoming opportunity. Now here you see it has formed the double bottom, apex of the double bottom was broken here. So at this particular area, can we find the value of, let me draw the value at zero. This is line of 20. We can see that here when the correction took place, the value of ADX remained above 20. So there was no strength in the downtrending move of the market. Similarly, what we can see here is, here there was a consolidation and so ADX was below 20. We can see ADX was below 20. We can see here, which means it was a sideways market. Now the moment it crossed above 20, here we can see the price was taking support at EMA 55 and finally there was a breakout. I can draw. You need to understand the various aspect of technical. There was a breakout here on 23rd July on this candle and you can see the ADX had gone past 20. So what we can see, yes, here there is a breakout and the strength in the trend is gaining momentum. Now here what we can see, if you are using this kind of window where there is a value of DI plus and DI minus, what we can see when here green color line had crossed over red color line, means the trend is reversing from bearish to bullish. You can see here it was a bearish move at this point and crossover indicated. So in this you can see at the point of crossover the reversal was taking place. At the same time the value of ADX was 20 was 21, which means it was above 20. So this is how you can use the, here you can see this DI plus is crossing under DI minus. So you can see the correction has taken place. So in order to have a less confusion of DI plus, DI minus and all those, one should use ADX line to find out only the strength part of it. However, the nature of the market is to be gauged with the market structure. If the market is making higher highs and higher lows, and we can make use of various moving averages to ascertain whether the market is in markup phase or markdown phase. So I am reviewing this window to explain further. What we can see here, the market corrected, double bottom formation, and after double bottom formation the apex was broken here. You can see multiple rejection and it was broken here. At this time the ADX value was above 20, so it is favorable, the strength was good in uptrending move. Here the breakout has taken place on this candle and we can see the ADX value was 17, but subsequently at this consolidation, little correction, and then again this candle was formed as a bounce back candle and ADX went past 20. So it was gaining momentum on upside. So it is very clear. So here is a right opportunity for a long trade. Similarly, if we have any downtrending market, we can initiate the sell. Here we can see it was a downtrending move where the price was making lower highs and lower lows kind of formation, and we can see the strength was good enough here at this point where we could have taken a short selling position. However, when the price is above SMA 233, one should not initiate a short sell. The purpose was to tell you if the value is ADX line is above 20, it indicates the strength in the prevailing trend. So if the market is trending up, it is in markup phase, and you find the value of ADX line above 20, the strength on uptrend is good. And when the market is in markdown phase and the value of ADX is above 20, the downtrend is strong enough to take the short selling opportunity in the market. So friends, if you have liked this presentation, give a lot of thumbs up to it, friends. Share this video among other people so that they can also benefit out of these kind of tutorials on the channel, and in the process, subscribe the channel to become part of your and my family, where learning is a continuous process. Friends, subscribe the channel, enable the notification bell so that you remain notified all the time and do not miss any kind of important video on this channel. Friends, thank you very much for watching. Looking forward to meet you again soon. Thanks a lot.